from what the planet is to how it could change how we view planets and more. Join me as we explore exoplanet TOI-849b and how it might be a gas giant that lost its gas. I want you to picture the two kinds of planets that we know about in the universe, solid rock-like planets and then gas giants. You know that both of them have cores, right? One is molten, or so we believe. We can't actually prove this without samples. And one is believed to be a compressed gas core. But as noted, it's really hard to prove these without actually going to the core and seeing it for ourselves. That is, until potentially right now, for one of these types of planets anyway. A distant world about 40 times more massive than Earth may be the remnant core of a giant planet, or a gas planet in the making, whose growth stalled, a new study reports. These findings may help shed light on what the mysterious cores of giant planets look like, researchers said, which would obviously be a big step towards not just researching planets, but understanding how they form, how they continue to live, and of course what happens when they die. Scientists investigated the exoplanet TOI-849b, which NASA's Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite, TESS, first detected in 2018, and whose existence the La Silla Observatory in Chile later helped confirm. This alien world orbits the sun-like star TOI-849 about 730 light-years from Earth. With a mass about 40 times that of Earth, TOI-849b is nearly half as massive as Saturn. At the same time, data from the Paranal Observatory in Chile and the Las Cumbres Observatory Global Telescope helped reveal that the exoplanet has a diameter about 3.45 times that of Earth, comparable to Neptune's. Altogether, this information suggests the exoplanet has a density similar to Earth's, making it the densest Neptune-sized planet discovered to date, which is quite a feat given all the planets that have been discovered in recent years from various telescopes, satellites, probes, and more. TOI-849b circles its star in a fast, tight orbit, just 18.4 hours long. This brings it scorchingly close to its star at a distance of just 1.5% of an astronomical unit, AU, the average distance between Earth and the Sun, which is about 93 million miles or 150 million kilometers. The newfound exoplanet therefore lies in the middle of the so-called hot Neptunian Desert, an apparent and mysterious dearth of Neptune-sized worlds that orbit very close to their stars. There are not a lot of planets in this in-between place, so to see a planet this size this close to a star is pretty cool, Sean Raymond, an astrophysicist at the Observatory of Bordeaux in France, who did not take part in this research, told Space.com. Cool indeed, except when you're the planet being scorched by the sun. But we're pretty sure it doesn't have feelings. Still, seeing a massive ball of gas like this be so close to its sun raises a lot of questions and wonders, which is why many scientists are very focused on this exoplanet, especially since the very existence of TOI-849b contradicts what many people think happened with gas giants depending on their size. Previous models suggested that Neson planets more than 10 to 20 times Earth's mass should have strong enough gravitational fields to gobble up huge amounts of material from the protoplanetary disks of gas and dust that surround their newborn stars. Such worlds should therefore swell to become gas giants similar to Jupiter or Saturn. As such, one might think that TOI-849b is the remnant of a gas giant that lost most of its weight somehow, perhaps due to the heat it experiences orbiting so close to its star. If this is true, this would create a whole new path for certain planets to go depending on their circumstances. And if this is the core of a former gas giant, it would be treated in a whole other way. However, as much as the light from TOI-849b's star would sear the exoplanet, the scientists noted such heating alone might still not strip a gas giant's atmosphere down to nearly the planet's core. They estimated the star is about 6.7 billion years old. Given that amount of time, as well as TOI-849b's distance from its star, they calculated a Jupiter-like gas giant would have lost only a few percent of its mass due to stellar radiation to date. Granted, this is just based on calculation and is not hard proof, but these models do seem to point to this not being a planet ravaged by a star, or at least this star it's orbiting. And it's fair to believe that, for now at least, because if more evidence or proof comes to life, it would obviously change things. As such, the researchers suggest that TOI-849b may be the remnant core of a gas giant that lost mass through a different mechanism. Perhaps it collided with other gas giants, for example, or the gravity of its star peeled off much of its gas envelope. Alternatively, if TOI-849b were slung to its current position due to gravitational clashes with other planets, the energy the exoplanet would have experienced as its star's gravity pulled TOI-849b into its current circular orbit would have greatly heated that world, potentially leading to significant mass loss. You might think, wait a minute, since when can stars be slung through the universe? Believe it or not, this happens a lot more than you think. You see, many things in the universe, even stars, are tethered to something. Planets are usually tethered to stars, like Earth with our own sun, and stars are tethered to the greater gravitational forces of the galaxy they're in. That's how orbits are made. But at times, these orbits are disrupted, and it leads to planets being flung from their orbits and put into space at blinding speed. These are known as rogue planets, and many exist in the universe. And of course, if done properly, stars could have this done to them too. And these planets and stars don't stop until they've collided with something or get caught by a strong gravity. Before we dive more into this unique planet or planet core, be sure to like or dislike the video. That way we can continue to improve and make the best videos possible for you. Also, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss any of our weekly videos. Another possible explanation for TOI-849b's current state has to do with Arrested Development, and no, we don't mean the TV show. Perhaps TOI-849b formed late, when much of its system's protoplanetary disk was gone, the researchers said. Alternatively, perhaps as TOI-849b developed an orbit around its star, it carved off all the material available to it for its growth within the protoplanetary disk. All in all, TOI-849b may give scientists a glimpse at what the core of a gas giant looks like. Future research may directly observe that core's composition by analyzing evaporated material in the exoplanet's remaining atmosphere. I'm sure some of you are wondering why we're focusing so hard on this potentially very unique planet or planet core. After all, we can't live on gas planets, or at the very least, the ability to do so via floating colonies or massive spacecraft are well beyond our league right now. Not to mention this particular planet, planet core, isn't exactly the closest thing around right now, you know? The answer lies in planet core itself, because it can be an answer to something we just don't know yet. And for many, the finding of the unknown is its own reward. Think about it. If we're able to prove that this is the core of a former gas giant, we could study it and learn all about how the core works and how it keeps the gas giants together and so on and so forth. This could lead to a brand new understanding that'll keep astronomers talking for a very long time, and could even lead to new possibilities and views on the planets that we already know. After all, we have a fleet of gas giants in our own solar system via Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. What is to say that learning more about this potential planet core couldn't lead to new things found out about our own gas giants? After all, we're still learning more about all four of them even now. From the discovery of the new moons around them to the sounds that they make. Jupiter in particular sounds really weird, a potential for moons with rings and so on and so forth. But what if we could study this potential core and then find a way to dive into one of the four giants that we have and observe their own core? That too could open up all sorts of things. And yes, it's true that at present we are a long way away from being able to live anywhere close to a gas giant, but that doesn't mean the possibility isn't out there. Sci-fi series have shown all sorts of versions of colonies and spacecrafts that hover above or orbit around gas giants in order to get certain things from them. Plus, with us potentially going to Mars this decade and starting a colony, it would make sense to want to learn even more about its neighbor in Jupiter, just in case there is something we don't know about their neighborly relationship that could affect the potential colonists that live there. In short, there is little doubt that while it may seem odd or foolish to want to learn more about these gas giants, it could eventually be proven vital in the long run. After all, the more you know, the more you can make evaluations about things that could turn out to be major stepping stones for humanity's expansion across the stars. If you're still on the fence about that, look at Mars again. Once upon a time, we thought it was just a barren red planet that we had no hopes of being on for one reason or another. And for a while, our tests and finding proved just that. But then, almost randomly, we found water on Mars. One of the things that you absolutely have in order to sustain life on a planet. And it was there. Then we started to dig deeper, and we found out that there are elements on Mars that could be used to not just build a colony, but fund it. Mainly in that there is indeed gold on Mars. Fast forward to now, and both NASA and SpaceX are aiming to launch missions to Mars this decade in order to start the potential colonization process. But where would that have been if they stopped early on and said, there's no way we can inhabit a planet such as this? We would still be on Earth in the grand scale. Various people wouldn't care about space. NASA wouldn't have gotten the surge in the arm that it did, and Elon Musk wouldn't be as successful as he is now with all the achievements SpaceX has made. Space isn't just a place to look at or even try and live in via its various planets and moons. It's a cornucopia of things that are begging to be discovered and explored and questioned. The more we look into space, the more things that we find in order to help flesh out the universe as a whole. There are still loads of things we don't know about the universe that we're trying to answer. Like, why is the universe still expanding billions of years after the Big Bang ended? Is there really dark matter and dark energy? Is there any hope of finding another Earth-like planet among the stars? And so on and so forth. Gas giants like TOI-849b make up a large majority of the planets in the universe. And the more we know about them, how they form, how they grow, and the things they can do, the more we're going to be prepared for when we are able to study them more up close, hopefully in the next few decades. Sure, we here right now may not be able to witness them up close, but someone will one day. You can bet on that, more than likely. And again, what separates TOI-849b from the other gas giants that we have seen is that it is very much unclear what led it to being like it is. It defies the models that we have about gas giants, and so we need to study it more. If it is a true planet, then we need to figure out how it got turned into what it is now. If it's the core of a former planet, then we need to not just study the core's contents, but figure out the process that led it not just to being a core again, but how it ended up on its current tether via the star it's orbiting. It's these questions that help fuel science and exploration. We need to come to the point where we are able to answer these questions and thus propel ourselves to the next level of knowledge about the universe. Because until we do that, we're always going to be asking how things work instead of actually figuring out how things work. Plus, if humanity really is to go beyond our solar system, we need to figure out more about the universe and be ready for all that may befall us. So why not study something now? Why wait for later? We may not get another chance like this in our lifetime. Thanks for watching, everyone. What did you think about this unique exoplanet? Is it really a planet, or is it a planet core? When do you think we'll finally get our answer as to what it possibly and truly can be? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.